Today's lecture is going to be how to analyze plane waves that come onto a boundary between two media in an oblique fashion. So here's a separation between two different materials, material number one and material number two. This is the normal to that boundary, the perpendicular to the boundary. And here's a plane wave that's coming in at a direction that is not perpendicular to the boundary. We call this oblique incidence just because it is not perpendicular. This represents the frontal plane waves as they are moving through space. There are two aspects of this plane wave that are going to be particularly important to us. One is the direction of propagation. We're going to call that ki with a unit vector because that's representing the direction that the wave is propagating. Here is the angle, theta I, relative to the normal, that tells us the direction of that plane wave. There's also going to be a reflected wave that comes off like this. The angle of the reflected wave, theta r, is equal to the angle of the incident wave, regardless of the two materials. We're going to call this vector kr with a hat over it. That's a unit vector in the reflected direction. And then finally, there's going to be a transmitted vector. We're going to call this kt for transmission. And there's going to be an angle here, theta t. We use Snell's law to be able to find all of the angles. The first thing that we indicated was that theta I and theta r are equal. The second thing is, depending on these two materials and theta I, we'll be able to find theta t. This is how it works. We can say that the index of refraction n, this is not eta, this is n, n1 times the sine of theta 1 is n2 sine of theta 2. If this is material number 1 and this is material number 2, this is n1 sine of theta incident equals n2 sine of theta t. N, for a lossless material, is the square root of epsilon r. Square root of epsilon r1, square root of epsilon r2. So this tells us how the angle of incidence affects the angle of transmission in a lossless, this assumes lossless, non-magnetic material. Non-magnetic means that mu r is equal to 1. This helps us analyze the different directions of propagation. And there's one other factor that's going to be very important, and that is the polarization of the plane wave. The polarization is defined by the electric field vector. So I'm going to draw two different choices for electric field vector here. One of them would be if the electric field vector came out of the board or the electric field vector went into the board. In this case, the electric field would be perpendicular to the board. We call the board the plane of incidence because it includes the direction of the propagation and it includes the normal to the boundary between the two materials. So if you have an electric field in either of these directions, this is a perpendicular polarized plane wave. On the other hand, you might have an electric field vector that is either up or down. And this electric field vector can be drawn on the plane of incidence, the blackboard, and this is therefore parallel to the plane of incidence. So we're going to do two different cases. One of them is going to be for a plane wave that is propagating in the perpendicular polarization, and the other one is a plane wave propagating in the parallel polarization. Now let's also look at where the magnetic field vector is. If I had a direction of propagation, such as my incident field here, and I had a perpendicular polarized electric field vector, let's figure out where the magnetic field vector is. The magnetic field vector can be found using the right-hand rule. We put our thumb in the direction of propagation, we put our first finger in the direction of E, and then our third finger shows us where H is. So H in this case is down like so. Let's look at this case. We put our thumb in the direction of propagation, we put our finger in the direction of E, our third finger will show us where H is. So for the electric field vector going up like so, H would be in this direction. So the two things that we've looked at so far are how to define the angles how to define the directions of propagation, how to determine if we are perpendicular or parallel polarized, and how to find the magnetic field vector.